Hi, I'm Dan Carnevale. We're here at the Power Systems Experience Center. I'm going to demonstrate high resistance grounding. If there's a ground fault in an ungrounded system, we can use high resistance grounding to limit the fault current to 3 amps. When we do that, you can see that the ground fault indication is here. And we can use pulsing contactors to figure out where that ground fault is on the power system. Then when the ground fault goes away, you can see it go back to zero here. We can have that indication here that we had a ground fault overnight. But when the ground fault goes away, we may want to clear it manually or automatically, depending on whether or not we want to have some indication. During a ground fault condition, when phase A, for example, goes to ground, the other two phases go to the line-to-line voltage, in this case, 480 volts. So it's like a corner-grounded delta system. When the ground fault goes away, when a ground fault occurs, I can use this current clamp going around the entire conduit. And when a ground fault occurs, the return current doesn't all go back up through the same ground path. It's kind of like a GFI in your bathroom in your house, where the current that goes in on the hot doesn't necessarily return in on the neutral. If there's a ground fault, it could go through any other grounded path. So when that occurs, we see this current in this path, and now we know that the ground fault is in this path, and it makes it easier to track down the fault. So when there's a ground fault, you can also use the pulsing contactor to show a difference in the current to make sure that you are on the right path. By the way, if the ground fault goes away, the current goes to zero, which is what you would expect. Normally when a ground fault occurs on an ungrounded system, a delta-delta system, for example, if you don't have high resistance grounding, by National Electric Code, you have to have 3 indicating lights. Phase A, phase B, phase C. Normally these are 480 volt rated lights, but they'll operate at 277. So this one's medium brightness, medium brightness, medium brightness. When a ground fault occurs, one of them will go out. Whatever phase the ground fault occurs on, that phase will go to zero. The other two will get bright. So you have, for example, 0 volts, 480, 480. And you'll know it's on phase A. The problem is that it's hard to indicate or try to find where the ground fault occurred. The only thing you know is it's on phase A, for example. So using high resistance grounding, you can use the current device and measure the current throughout conduits throughout the system and try to figure out where exactly the ground fault is. If there's a ground fault on an ungrounded system, it's a little bit like this. If I rub my feet on the carpeting and I build up a static charge on my finger, I could have 5 kV on the end of my finger. Until I touch something or somebody with it, it's not going to discharge. So I hold that DC trap charge. Power system's a lot like that. In fact, the power system is very capacitive in that sense if it's ungrounded. On a power factor correction capacitor, on a capacitor, we put resistors to bleed off the DC trap charge. So you see, like if we have a ground fault here in the power system and we take away the ground fault, if we have a ground fault in an ungrounded power system and we take away the AC voltage, we have a DC trap charge on the power system. But the problem is if there's an arcing ground, the next time the ground fault occurs, we could be up here, and the next time it occurs, it could be higher. So we have this higher and higher DC trap charge. What happens eventually is either the power system itself will flash over from phase to ground, usually through some kind of conductors or transformers or motors, or surge protectors fail in that case where you have a high overvoltage related to ground DC trap. So in summary, if you use high resistance grounding and this current clamp, you can go around and track down ground faults that might occur, especially with a pulsing system, without having to worry about arcing ground faults that might raise the voltage on the power system on an ungrounded system. So you still get the free ground fault, and you can track it down with this. If you're looking for more information, you can find it in this brochure or on our website.